There is no other sports car manufacturer that has won so many titles and so many different championships than Lotus. And that's a rich tradition.
With this car, we have been inspired by the motorsport heritage. For example, that concave section that we see above the door. This mix is quite unique on this car. A design oriented to the maximum efficiency.
It's very lightweight, two-seater, convertible, very, very quick and versatile.
The Elan is a sports car for everyday use. It might well be the one and only car in the household, so you can use it driving to work and home, but you can also use it on the weekend.
Elan is positioned somewhere in between the Elise and the Esprit. It's a very powerful machine. It's got over 450 or 470 horsepower.
I've been inspired by Formula One that Mario Andretti used in 78. The car is very skinny. There is a tribone and the rest is all muscle. Very symbolic of what you expect from a Lotus.
What Lotus has achieved in the past 60 years is something very, very outstanding. I'm convinced that with the new product lineup and with the new strategy Lotus has now, it will continue to deliver the next 60 years.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
But it's just great to come and see all the cars and all the faces that you see as you go round, because I do go to the shows north and south of the country, which is great. And you're just seeing people all the time that you recognise and just have a nice chin wag. It's lovely.
Well, I came back from Singapore years ago, and my uncle picked me up at the airport in a brand new, just delivered Mark 10. And I sat in it and I looked at all that walnut and all that leather. I thought, one day I'm going to have a Jaguar. And I think I'm on my 12th.
They're iconic. It's they've always been, you know, whatever William Lyons used to do, the Jaguars were always that bit different from your ordinary run-of-the-mill cars. It's just, I don't know, it's just something that you grow up with.
I fell in love with them, I suppose, when my uncle had a brand new one just after the war. Then I rode in a Mark V in about 1952, and then I followed while I was at school all the successes at Le Mans.
Well, we did Route 66 a year ago. We shipped it to the States and did it from one side to the other, 3,000 miles. The car is used a lot now. I think I've had it in the last 3 years, it's done 30,000 miles. And last year we nearly approached 14,000 miles in 1 year.
We have these fantastic icons that were penned by Sir William Lyons. This car was actually drawn by Sir William Lyons. And we look back to these icons, the XKs, the D-types, the C-types, that have so much richness of design. So to actually be part of these cars today, be amongst these cars today, is very stimulating. So undoubtedly, I'll be taking this day back to the drawing board with me at some point in the future.
We left Coventry Transport Museum, and of course Coventry is the spiritual home of Jaguar, and drove down here to the vineyard. And we've had a great drive, some super roads really, and we're in the C-type, so what could be better?
We'll be right back. R&D department. We have a clear vision about the super sports cars. We have a brand which is uncompromising, extreme and Italian. I drive a Lamborghini on a daily basis. So it's one of the most exciting things I do in the morning, and usually it's one of the best things I do in the evening when I drive home. If we talk about the vision or what the super sports cars are all about, it's very easy because it's about design and performance. So if you have these key elements, it's pretty easy, let's say, to decline what the business is in future is going to look like, because these key elements are not going to change.
We are going to show at the Paris Motor Show a technological demonstrator, and this technological demonstrator will have the name Sesto Elemento. Sesto Elemento, why? Because on the periodic system, the carbon fiber is on place number 6. So this is the reason why. And why? Because this car is all about power to weight ratio. So we will have, and I'll give you just in 4 numbers what this car is all about. It has a V10 engine, 5.2 liter capacity with 570 horsepower. It has less than a ton, so 999 kilos of weight. We have 1.75 kilos per horsepower, and we have an acceleration from 0 to 62 in just 2.5 seconds. And this is just wow, and the design is outstanding of this car. And it's completely made out of carbon fiber.
You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. The AutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.
It's a living art. It's definitely something very special, which is different from any other objects in its refinement, in its proportion, in its detail, but also in its, in the whole composition. It's a great piece of art.
If you look at the very first sketch, This car is so close, you could almost overlay the car next to the sketch, which means that we haven't compromised the designer's thought and the engineer's thought into the car at all. It's as we first intended.
It's a very complicated project because to do a one-off, it's probably easy. But to do 77 one-offs is more complicated.
Incredible journey. When you finally see the car moving, there's an amazing sound to the engine, but there's a grace and a fabulous movement to the car when you see it on the track. It actually does make the hairs on the back of my neck stand up still.
Well, everybody is of course excited about such a project because for most people it is a one-off in their life to do something like this. Now it's all about the details, refinement, getting it all in the proper composition. I do think it demonstrates the quality of the team and the people.
We've pushed the boundaries of what an Aston Martin can actually look like. It's opened many, many doors for us in terms of developing the language of Aston Martin, the DNA of Aston Martin. My favorite line is actually the line that comes off the top of the headlamp. It goes all the way down the side of the car, all the way around the back of the car and joins to the other side. And it's one single line that from any angle, it looks perfect. It's both simple but complex at the same time.
This car has everything to become a classic, but at the moment it's the most modern, advanced a car, and it's not a classic. It is the car, it is the concept, it's the whole thing, it's the composition as a whole, which is great.
There is a combination of power, brutality, grace, elegance, which the car gives.
Yeah, I see the beauty, I see the power, I see the soul, I see the craftsmanship, I see the piece of art.
Will remain a beautiful car way out into the future, and that's how we will always approach design at Aston Martin.
This is alive. It is much more than a sculpture. It's living art.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews. Our objective when developing the ride and handling of the new Civic was to create a very rigid body to give the suspension a good base to work from. This allowed us to maximize comfort and provide an agile, sporty drive. The new Civic is not just an evolution. In terms of ride quality, we have made a step equivalent to two generations of development. We have spent more time testing in Europe than with any previous Honda model. We have worked with our Japanese colleagues to guarantee a very good performance on European roads, where you combine high-speed running with some very bad road surfaces. We have continued to use a torsion beam rear suspension system, which is very compact and allows us to maximize the space in the cabin. But we have increased the stiffness of the beam to provide much more stable handling. And we have developed a unique fluid-filled compliance bushing that allows us to achieve an excellent balance between comfort and sporty handling. Every time we visited Europe during the development of the car, we achieved significant improvements in the ride and handling, tuning the car for the local demands. We want the driver to feel excited when they sit behind the steering wheel of the new Civic. I'll be proud to present this car in Frankfurt, where we will meet our toughest competitors. We have reached our targets, but we will never stop evolving and improving.
Wir müssen natürlich die verschiedenen Fahrzustände, Bedingungen, äußeren klimatischen Bedingungen berücksichtigen. Aus dem Grund müssen wir auf der ganzen Welt testen, angefangen von Südafrika über Frankreich, Schweden, am Nürburgring. Schnee ist eine Bedingung, ist ein Fahrzustand, wo man sehr feinfühlig agieren können muss, wo die Systeme sehr gut aufeinander abgestimmt sein müssen. Wenn ein System nicht zum anderen passt, hat man ein Problem. Man kann das Fahrzeug nicht optimal an Grenzbereiche heranführen. sehr simple oder einfache Übung ist das Anfahren am Berg. Aber hier kann man sehr gut die Komplexität zeigen, wo die Regelsysteme mittlerweile beherrschen müssen. Ich stehe jetzt mit meinem Fuß, mit meinem rechten Fuß auf der Bremse. In dem Moment, wo ich aufs Gaspedal übergehe, muss das DSC-Regelsystem weiterhin den Bremsdruck aufrechterhalten. Und zwar so lange, bis der Motor übernimmt und sanft Gas gibt, damit kein Rückrollen ist.
Getestet wird es hauptsächlich, indem man Autos kalt oder beziehungsweise über Nacht stehen lässt, auf der Höhe sauber durchkühlen lässt, in der Früh seinen Kaltstart macht, anständig alles mitmisst und dann geht es ans Fahren. Kalt abfahren, kalt den Berg hochfahren, kalt den Berg runterfahren. Das sind alles die Themen, die wir von der Motorapplikation in den Griff kriegen müssen.
Okay, Messung läuft. Startknopf. Und los. Ach da gut, man sieht einen schönen Drehzahlverlauf. Das Schwingen ist nicht optimal, aber das kriegen wir jetzt noch hin. Wir sind ja noch in der Applikationsphase.
I don't ever think of myself as a collector. In my mind, they are like parts of me. Cars are fun and toys, and they all offer you a different experience. To me, they're works of art. The older cars, the details, the metalwork were done by artisans. And as time has changed, they had more sophistication in the new technology. But the cars that I love, the cars that I collect and drive, are still special. Cars have always inspired me. There are details on cars that I've loved and have utilized those details in watches and furniture. I believe in cars as being works of art. It's technology, it's mechanics, it's details, and to me that's a special kind of art. I enjoy getting in the car and turning the key and moving. The beauty of the drive, the beauty of the way it feels, and at the same time, the beauty of the look.
I'm a museum curator and I'm used to install exhibitions of paintings and drawings. So this is much more difficult. Everything has to be done with an extreme precision. Well, I don't mean that when you install paintings you can just be imprecise, but there, for instance, usually you first install the whole museography, the whole scenography, and then the works of art start to arrive. Here, because of the space, we had to do it little by little, which is very different. Also, the weight of those objects and the difficulty to have them climb the stairs is something very special. But this is also what will give the beauty of the exhibition, because when you will arrive, those cars will be elevated and you will discover them from they will be in, at the top, and it is very important, but it's very demanding, you know. I chose to focus on a period on history in history when for the public the evolution of car bodies and car technique is quite obvious, because it starts with cars where the mechanical aspect is very strong and can be seen from the outside, and this is the 30s, and it ends in at the beginning of the 60s with a Ferrari 250 LM, where everything is wrapped in a very beautiful shape, which is aerodynamic. And then Mr. Loren had the good idea to add the McLaren, which is 1996, and which linked with that Ferrari, show that Ferrari arrived to a step in classicism in the design of the body, and the McLaren has the same proportions, the same space for the driver, the same place for the engine, which is in the back of the driver. Those two cars are very close and very different at the same time. So the issue of the exhibition is to give the public, only by looking at the cars, the idea of an evolution of technique and of creation, and what's on a man's mind when he creates a car. So there is a progression in that exhibition from 1929 to 1961 and later. The choice was to create links between the objects. Exactly when you make an exhibition on paintings, you just don't put paintings on the walls like that. You have to create a kind of way that brings the eye from one painting to another. I tried to do the same with the cars. For instance, when you look on the same level to the Porsche Spyder and the Jaguar XKD, I hope that you can understand that they are not at all conceived with the same idea. With the Porsche, the engine is in the back, the Jaguar is in the front, and so on and so on. They are very, very different. The Porsche is air-cooled, the Jaguar is water-cooled, and so on. But they are both 1955, and they get some family look. Very low, very aerodynamic. The color is different, but the shape have a kind of... they look partner in some project, which means that they look, the factories looked at each other just like artists looked at each other. So that was the purpose, that was how I did the choice. For me, cars are art pieces. They are just art pieces that can move, and movement, speed, sound is part of the artistic content. So that's why we chose to have two rooms where you can hear recordings of the cars to create that impression that the car is not only, it is a sculpture, they are presented like sculptures on podiums and so on, but we wanted also to have that aspect of movement. And also we have worked with the Bewley Museum on archive films, and we have found some films where you see the cars that are exhibited in action in the 30s, you know. So it's very important to understand that they are sculptures, but they are not only sculptures. They also can be driven, and be driven fast, and this is part of their artistic aspect.
Thank you. for watching The Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.